In this video, I am going to discuss previous year NEET questions 2012, 9, 11, 10, 7, all. So some good number of questions I have selected, organic chemistry sequence questions I am going to do. Okay, so organic chemistry. Sequence question. Today I have selected chapter alcohols, phenols, ethers. Alcohols, phenols, and ethers. Williamson ether synthesis separately I am going to explain. Which is suitable alkyl halide, which is not suitable. If you take bridged halogen, it follows SN2 mechanism or E2 mechanism or none. Why? What is the reason? So I am going to explain separately Williamson ether synthesis and HI. Some questions I have selected in today's explanation. Remaining questions next video I can do. So first let's begin with previous year question 2012 sequence question. This is frequently we are seeing in organic chemistry papers. CH3Br treated with KCN. So we are getting A. This A further reacted with water, hydrolysis. H plus in presence of water, hydrolysis. We'll get B. B further treated with lithium aluminium hydride. We'll get C. So here what is C they're asking? Options also they had given students to save the time. If I'm writing all options, it may take more time. Instead of that, we can do number of questions, right? So try to give answer students. So here the first step to increase carbon, I'm writing important points also. To increase carbon chain, definitely, so we can treat with KCN. This is the best one, students. See, CH3Br treated with KCN. So this is alcoholic KCN. Nucleophilic substitution reaction with CN. Cyanides will come. With AgCN, isocyanates will come. We have studied in previous chapter, right? See, previous chapter and this chapter, both they are connecting. C triple bond N, right? Afterwards, they are doing hydrolysis. Whenever cyanide hydrolysis bond cleavage here, you will get acids. You will get acids. CH3C double bond OH. This is like ammonia gas. It will go. So further, it treated with lithium aluminium hydride. What is lithium aluminium hydride? Reduction, students. How easily we can write the reduced products, reduction products. I had uploaded videos, starting videos, reduction. So please follow. So then you'll come back to this question. Easily you can work out. Okay. Acids where cleavage, students? What we have discussed in that video? Here cleavage. Here H. Byproduct is water. What is the main product here? Aldehyde. Is it your answer C? No, it is not your answer C. See further, what is this active site is there? Still a bond is there, a double bond. Again it can break. Again add H here, H here. That's it. One bond breaking means two hydrogens you have to add. Here also bond breaking, adding hydrogen. So finally, what is your answer, students? CH3CH2OH. Clear? That's all. This is ethyl alcohol. So finally, what is C here? Ethyl alcohol. Okay. So this combination compulsory we have to learn, students. After that, they're giving alcoholic OH, aqueous KOH, KCN, hydrolysis. Next one, KMnO4 reactions. This is frequently asking question. Now, question 2. Question 2, 2009. 2009. ethanol. What is ethanol? Just now we made ethanol, right? That's why I have selected this question. CH3, CH2OH. Now this one treated with PBr3. So what is A? What is X? X further treated with alcoholic KOH. We have got Y. Y further treated with H2SO4, room temperature. Okay, H2O. So this is nothing but dilute H2SO4. Adding water means dilute H2SO4. So okay, now this is Z. What is X, Y, Z they are asking. So can you try this one? See, this is PBr3. Okay, actually ratios also they are asking. 1 mole of PBr3 reacting means 3 moles we have to provide. 3 moles of ethyl alcohol treated with 1 mole of PBr3. Then you will get, what is this? 3 moles of, what is this answer? CH3CH2Br. This is nucleophilic substitution reaction, SN reaction. OH is replaced by bromine. PBr3 have capability to give 3 nucleophiles. That's why here also we have to provide 3 nucleophiles. That's why we are taking 3 moles. This is also one of the important. Already I had explained in our previous video. So go through our channel, you'll come to know. Okay, alcoholic KOH. Alcoholic KOH, stage of role, importance of the reagents I had given. Go through the channel, then definitely you will get command reagents. Alcoholic KOH means dehydrohalogenating reagent. From alpha carbon, halogen. From beta carbon, hydrogen. That's it, students, now. So here alpha carbon, this one, here beta carbon. Here we have only one beta carbon. There is no issue. Sometimes you will get more than 2 beta carbons. Then we have to follow Sage-Jeff rule. So what is this? More substituted alkene is a major product. But what I gave shortcut to you? Poor become poorer, right? So like that. That's why Sage-Jeff rule, Markenkoff rule, go through the channel. You will come to know more if you have any confusions. Room temperature, water, that means dilute H2SO4. That means finally indirect addition of water. That's it. Okay, symmetrical alkenes, no need to take any rule. So unsymmetrical alkene is the Markenkoff rule. Here OH, here H. Or else here OH, here H also, final answer is same. See, students, starting one also ethyl alcohol, end also ethyl alcohol. Sometimes to confuse the student, they will give. So student will think, starting ethanol means definitely answer is not ethanol. No, it's not like that. You have to do sequence question. If you know the importance of the reagent, you people definitely enjoy sequence question. Okay. If you have command, no problem. If you don't have command also, no problem. Already have uploaded important reagents in our channel, 3 parts. Please go through that point before going to the examination. Afterwards, rules, rearrangement reactions also have uploaded. Now, next question, 2009. Question 3. Phenol. Phenol treated with zinc dust. Zinc dust will get A. A further treated with CH3Cl in presence of AlCl3. We have got here B. B treated with alkaline KMnO4. This is a drastic condition. Alkaline KMnO4 and acidic KMnO4. See, phenol with zinc dust. This is one of the common questions. Zinc dust is acts as a reducing agent. Reducing agent is nothing but it remove oxygen or addition of hydrogen. Anything will do. Okay, here removing oxygen. That's it. What is A here? Benzene. That's it. Now afterwards, this is what? Friedel-Crafts alkylation. Friedel-Crafts alkylation. What is electrophile? Alkylium ion. He will go and attack. Anywhere it can attack. No problem. Okay, CH3. If somebody is there on benzene ring, that group influence the coming electrophile. If no one is there, anywhere it can attack. There is no issue. There is no issue. So finally, what we have got here? alkyl benzene. Alkyl benzene. What is its name? Methyl benzene. Exact name? Toluene. So toluene further treated with alkaline KMnO4. Students, your note point. Not only methyl, ethyl, isopropyl, any big long chain like this. Benzene ring, something group, long chain, or else you can take it isopropyl group. Any alkyl benzene. If you treat with alkaline KMnO4, finally we will get just bond breaking here. Add COOH. That final group converting into one carbon acid. That's it. So finally, what is this guy name? Benzoic acid. Clear, students? That's it. Now, question number 4. Question 4. Phenol treat with chloroform in presence of NaOH. So what is the product? O minus Na and this is CHO. Okay, so here 2018 question, ma, this is NEET 2018 question. What are these questions? See, here reaction, entire reaction they had given. Sometimes they will ask the reaction name. Sometimes they will ask your intermediate. But here they asked intermediate. Anyone have idea, students? What is this reaction? Yes. Riemer-Thiemann reaction. Riemer-Thiemann reaction. That's it. Clear? Your intermediate is carbene. Carbene, CCl2, carbene. It is weak electrophile. It is weak electrophile. Any question you may expect here. See how it is a chloroform, this combination. Not only NaOH, you may take potassium hydroxide also. Alcoholic potash also sometimes they will give. If they give alcoholic potash, your K. That's it, students. Now look into this, students. Chloroform. Acidic in nature. Why acidic in nature? NaOH, no, our combination. See, he is the base. He is acts as acid. How can you say it is acid? Minus I groups. Electron withdrawing groups is there. Acidity increases. He is electron withdrawing groups. Electrons taking from carbon. Then carbon is taking from hydrogen. Then this bond is weak. Weak means he is going fast. He's leaving hydrogen, he's losing hydrogen. That means acidic in nature. Who will abstract this one? That's it. Final byproduct is water. And what about the main one? This is clear. So who is taking this bond? Carbon. That's right. You can write electrons. And lone pair and three strong electron withdrawing groups there on carbon, it can't bear. It is highly unstable. Immediately it loses one carbon. So finally, what you will get here? Carbene is intermediate. So this is important. This one further reacts with OH, then you will get the product. Okay. But here, what is the question? In this reaction, what is the intermediate they're asking? This is carbene, that is acts as weak electrophile. So I am covering more points. Why? Because if they ask, suppose, Reaction name also you have to learn. But how it is generated? So that is also the last. Is it weak electrophile, strong electrophile? The last. So that's why I'm covering all the questions here. Now, next one. 2018 question. Okay. Identify major product. Major product, question number 5. Identify major product P, Q, R in the following sequence. Sequence of reaction. Okay. Now I am giving. See what is the reaction? Benzene. Okay. Here they have taken N-propyl chloride, student. N-propyl chloride, or else 1-chloropropane. Your wish. This is anhydrous AlCl3. This is the combination you are seeing, means alkyl halide, anhydrous AlCl3. This is what is the reaction? Friedel-Crafts reaction. Friedel-Crafts reaction, right? Okay, here what they are asking, we are getting A. This A further treated with oxygen in presence of H3O plus heat. So then what are Q and R? Here you will get Q plus R. What is P? So this is better to take P. What is P? What is Q? What is R? They are asking. Can you guess what is the answer, students? This is one of the familiar named reaction. No? Cumene to phenol preparation. Are you remember? Are you remember? The students, what happened here? Benzene first treated with N-propyl chloride. Here, N-propyl chloride, first what happened? AlCl3, it abstract the chlorine. First step, abstract the chlorine. Okay, so byproduct is AlCl4 here. So AlCl4 minus. So here, what is the main one? CH3, CH2, CH2 plus. This is what, students? Primary carbocation. Primary carbocation is unstable. If any chances is there, it converting into 2 degree, it converting into 3 degree. If 3 degree chances is not there, it will go to the definitely 2 degree. Here how it is? Hydride shift. So what is this expanded form you can write, students? Then you will get to know easily. CH2 plus, right? This hydride shift takes place. Then what you will get here? CH3 plus CH3. This guy now will go and attack on benzene ring. Don't try directly attacking. This is a propyl benzene. Don't try. That is not our answer. Your answer is CH3. This is what, students? Methyl groups I have written and H. This is what? Isopropyl benzene. Isopropyl benzene. Isopropyl benzene, common name cumene. Clear? This is your answer P. Answer P. I think after that you understood my point. What is this? Cumene further treated with oxygen. In presence of oxygen, air. Nothing but what you will get? Cumene peroxide. Right? How easily you can write this step? Look into this. CH3, CH3H. Right? Now oxygen. Addition of oxygen. That's it. Here, as it is, you can write this methyl group, this methyl group. Just add two oxygens here. That's it. Right? Afterwards, we are treating with what? Heating. H plus. Okay, now, just migration. Just migration. This benzene ring migrates here. Migration. What you will get here, we are not removing anything, students. Phenol and byproduct CH3. You can write CH3 and O, double bond. That's it. This is what? Acetone. This is what? Phenol. This is your Q and R. Okay. Sometimes they are asking only P. Sometimes they are asking Q, R also. Only sometimes they are asking R. Any type of question. Okay. Clear, students? Now, 2011 question. This is a rearrangement question, students. Rearrangement reactions already I have uploaded. Please go through our channel, get command there. Next, see. CH3, what is the question number, students, now? How many questions we had completed? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is 6th question, right? Okay. CH3, CH, CH3, CH, OH, CH3. Your H plus heat. Okay. I am getting A plus B. Your A is major. A is major. And B is minor. Okay. Next. This A further treated with HBr. In the HBr dark. The two. Absence of peroxide. Note down this point. Absence of peroxide means it follows which rule? m's role, nor Genkov role, right? So we are getting here again two products C. One is major, another one is minor. So finally, write A and B, A and C. Find out A and C. Write A and C. Only major products they are asking. Can you try this one, students? Can you try? Okay. Along with me, you also try. So first, H plus heat is nothing but what, students? We are removing water, right? We are removing water. First step, you can check it. OH group. First, we'll remove OH group. CH3, this is CH, yes. OH, next what? CH3, right? So H plus heat, first step what we are removing? OH. After that we can remove H. Before removing H, some rearrangement takes place. Are you remembered? So see, what is this? CH3, right? CH, right? CH plus, this is CH3. So here we removed OH minus, clear? So now students, afterwards what happened? This is secondary carbocation. What I said, secondary chances is there, definitely it rearranges to tertiary. Yes, definitely. Here, yes, I am writing expanded form here itself. Students, usually you can understand this hydrogen hydride shift takes place. That's it. So shifting migrating power also hydride, then phenyl, then alkyl. Alkyl methyl. Alkyl group, any tertiary is there, first to tertiary. Already I have uploaded, please. Check it, CH3. This is what? 3-degree carbocation. Now, this 3-degree carbocation, you can take it as alpha. This is what? Beta carbon. This is beta carbon. This is beta carbon. Poor become poorer. Poor become poorer. Page of rule. Removing hydrogen. Where we have to remove hydrogen? Where poor hydrogens are there. Where poor hydrogens are having carbon. There only we are removing. So now tell me, what is the answer? Here we are removing. That's it. That's it. CH3. This is what, students? Double bond. CH3. Right? This is A. This is major. Minor, out of these two carbons you can. But they're not asking minor, no? Major. A we have got finally. Afterwards, what they're doing? HBr. Right? HBr, HBr, what is this? Dark condition. Absence of peroxide. Absence of peroxide means what is the rule it follows? Yes, M's rule. What I gave shortcut to you, M's rule. What is the shortcut I gave, students? Rich become richest. Rich become richest, right? Are you remembered? Yes, this is actocide. Where which hydrogens, out of these two carbons, where which hydrogens? This one. Now he became richer. Shortcut we used so that you can follow. And here what we are adding, HBr, no? Rich become richer. H add here, Br pulled up. So opposite. CH2, CH. That's it. 1, 2, 3, 4. Right? So what is this? 2-bromo, 2-methyl-butane. This is our answer C, major. Minor, ulta. Here, Br, here, H. Minor, they are not asking. Major. Clear? It will take time, students, but once you catch the logic, definitely you can enjoy the organic chemistry more. Next, 7th question, 2020. What is this? Anisole. What is this? Anisole. Anisole. Also call it as methoxybenzene. Methoxybenzene. This methoxybenzene cleavage. HI. And then what happened? Where it is cleavage? Suppose here cleavage. No. See, students, look into this. If it cleaves here, it is highly unstable carbocation generated. Phenyl carbocation, never. So that's why cleavage here. Cleavage here. After cleavage, this is O minus, this is plus. Why O minus? You are given phenoxide ion, no? Phenoxide ion is more stable, no? That's why phenoxide ion formation is easy. Where is O minus? There only H plus will go and attack OH. And finally, one answer CH3I. They're asking two products here. Clear, students? They're asking question. Anisole treated with HI. What are the products? Possible products. What are the possible products? That's it. Clear? Now go to the next question. Next, 8-1, 2010 sequence question. Which of the following compounds has the most acidic nature? Which of the following compounds has the most acidic nature? Okay, see students, questions. This is CH2OH, benzyl alcohol. Next one, this is phenol. And the third one, cyclohexanol. And the fourth one is something alcohol only. Alcohol only. Like this, they are given. Which is more basic? This is benzyl alcohol. This is alcohol. This is cyclohexanol. This is OH group. This is OH group. But this is phenol, no? So compared to alcohols and phenols, which is more acidic? Which is more acidic? Phenols are more acidic. So like that, we have to pick out the answer. Okay. Now, next question. Question number 9, 2020. Grignard reagent questions already I have uploaded, students. CH3, C double bond O CH3. Acetone treated with Grignard reagent methyl magnesium chloride. What is the answer? What is the answer? CH3 minus here. Right? So that's all. Grignard reagent. Clear explanation I had given 2 to 3 videos, students. Please, everybody must watch. Okay, next, easy writing Grignard reagent product. Further reversal of charge is not possible, just to hydrolysis. Just to hydrolysis, then what you will get here? This is what? Tertiary butyl alcohol. Here they are asking name. Is it secondary butyl alcohol, tertiary butyl alcohol, or else isopropyl alcohol or isobutyl alcohol? They are asking. This is answer name, tertiary butyl alcohol. Okay, now next one. Almost alcohol chapter, I am covering alcohols, phenols, ethers. Next one, copper reactions, they are asking. 2019, this is question. 2019 question. When vapors of secondary alcohol, is passed over heated copper at 573 Kelvin, the product formed is. Okay, I am explaining all the steps here, students. Actually, carboxylic acid, aldehyde, ketone, alkene option they are given. Which option? You only tell me after explanation. See, all questions I am covering here, copper. Copper dehydrogenation. Copper we are using means we are removing hydrogenation. So first, let me take primary alcohol. Primary alcohol treated with copper, 300 degrees of sometimes they are giving temperature in terms of Kelvin, sometimes degrees, both. How easily we can write the product C? See students, copper, what I said, copper if you are using, immediately remember what is the step, dehydrogenation, that means removing hydrogen. You can remove these two hydrogens, that's all your answer. This is what primary alcohol gives aldehyde. Now what is our question? Secondary alcohols. Can you try the same way? Can you try the same way, students? Check it. Yes. Secondary alcohols. Secondary alcohols. Again, copper, 573 Kelvin or 300. Dehydrogenation. Again here. Removing two hydrogens. All this is your answer, ketone. Your answer is here. This question, right? You can write secondary alcohol treated with copper, you will get ketones, right? Now, if they had given tertiary alcohol, what happens, students? See, tertiary alcohols are more reactive. Instead of dehydrogenation, dehydration happens. Tertiary alcohol, right? C1, 2, this is a tertiary, this is tertiary alcohol. Remove this hydrogen. Okay, now treat with copper, 573 Kelvin. Here we are removing water, important note point. 3 degree alcohol more reactive. More reactive. We'll remove water. The two from alpha carbon H, beta carbon hydrogen. Alpha carbon, this is right. This is beta carbon. This is beta carbon. This is beta carbon. All beta carbons are same. Anywhere you can remove. Anywhere you can remove. So CH3. Double bond CH2, CH3. This is what we call it as isobutylene. 1 year maybe they asked secondary alcohols converting copper treated with what is the product they're asking. Maybe this year they may ask copper tertiary, 3 degree alcohols, maybe primary alcohols. That's the reason I have covered all the points. Please follow it. Now, next question. C4H10O, how many alcohols? How many alcohols? How many ethers possible? How many alcohols? How many ethers possible? Next one. Next one. How many primary alcohols possible? This question you only work out. Comment me answer. In coming days, next video, before explanation of sequence question, other chapter, I will give solution for this. Okay. Now last question. Last question, students, your CHI reaction. CH3, OCH3, HI reaction. Generally, HI favors SN2. But if you take bulky groups, no, it favors the SN1. First, protonation takes place, students. After protonation, so I'm explaining here. 1 second. Separately, I can write this. CH3, protonation takes place. Here, oxonium ion plus, right? Oxonium ion state is unstable. Definitely, just no H came, no, that's why it will not leave. Either bond breaking here or bond breaking here will take place. If bond break here, what happens? If it is plus charge, it is more stable. Why? Because this is tertiary carbocation, right? 3 degree carbocation. 3 degree carbocations are more stable. If you will get here positive, if you give positive charge also, it can bear, it can stable. So then, what is this? This is what student? CH3, OH, that's it. So what is our answer? CH3 plus, and you can write CH3OH. Right? He is, after breaking, his this electrons is taking, this minus and plus get cancelled, nullify CH3OH. And here, wherever plus charge is there, then I minus is there, no? H plus I minus, no? I minus will go and attack. What is your answer? Tertiary butyl iodide. Right? Next, I am giving one question to you. CH3, CH2, CH2, O, CH3. Okay, here HI. This is methyl propyl ether. This is, it favors SN2 mechanism. SN2 mechanism means simple alkyl halides. Your cleavage, that's it. So see, this is simple alkyl halides. Here I, here H. That's it. Simple way you can make it. Clear, students? So with this maximum questions, I have covered alcohol, phenol, ethers. But I asked you one question. What is that? C4H10O. How many alcohols? How many ethers? How many primary alcohols? So without seeing, without reading proper way, students going for the answer. They're asking alcohols means you can write how many alcohols you are getting. But they're asking primary alcohols means you have to check it properly. So that's why I gave homework to you this question. Everybody try to do. What is the answer? Comment me if it is correct or not. Coming days video, I will give the answer. Okay, students, thank you. Thanks for watching. And before going to the examination, definitely it is useful videos, organic chemistry. And go through all organic chemistry parts in our channel. Page of rule, Hoffman's rule, Morkenkopf rule, rearrangement reactions, reagent questions, all. Definitely you will get command here. Thank you. Thanks for watching, and please inform it to your friends also. Definitely it is useful. Thank you, students.